Okay, we're out here in Oneida, New York, doing a little window shopping. It is the 2nd of January 2023. Basically, we're on the main stretch here. We got all the way down this way is going up towards what is it? Like Madison County would be up that way. This is actually Madison County. Down this way, if you were to keep going, you'd run into the little town of Cheryl. You don't like where they make Oneida silverware. This here, it's Napa Auto Parts. So it looks like they got
everything for your auto car accessories and needs.
What do they got?
Right here, looks like we've got some interest in these like this. Yeah. Price Chopper over there. Monday through Friday, 7:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Saturday, 8 a.m. 1 p.m. Sundays are closed.
Need anything on a Sunday here in Oneida? This is not the place to go. And then back up this way.
We've got Popeyes. So for all of you that have been to Popeyes, I want you to share your experience, because the experience that I had at Popeyes down in Boston, not a good one. I'll just leave it at that. But I would have to say Popeyes and KFC are definitely something different. So we got somebody over here checking us out real quick. Kind of hard to see through the windows.
I guess if you back out like that, it's a little easier.
Once you start zooming in, the zoom wants to focus on certain things. It's not. It's not usually what's inside the car. It's usually what's or inside the building. It's usually what's reflecting through the window.
So I really think it's important to get these videos. Thank you. Do these videos unedited. Because there's a lot of pushback right now with police and elected officials saying that these videos are highly edited to make them look bad. And I just don't think that's the case. I mean, I will say that, you know, I've been out and done probably 10 of these videos. And I've only come up with 3 half-assed videos. And I will say that, you know, I think that this whole movement is being cast in a certain way, and it's not what you think it is. When you go out there and you do an audit, 9 times out of 10, nothing happens. It's just a boring audit. After that,
I would say that basically, I'd say 9 times out of 10, you're getting anything that's no contact.
Big Lots. Got a drive-through down here. Guy just waved. Got a waiver in here too.
So this is also where the Oneida Indian Reservation is. It's just up the street off of Territory Road. That's a no-go. Same laws that apply here do not apply there. Share a story with you. I was at another break in the muffler place where I had my oil changed in my Chevy Celebrity. I just purchased this car used with less than 40,000 miles on it, and it was, God, I probably had it for 6 months. I took it over there, got the oil changed, and on my way to Buffalo that day, the motor shot a rod. And I lost all my oil out of the car, and obviously the motor was destroyed. Come to find out, they actually forgot to take the ring off the oil filter, and it had like a double oil filter on it, or a double seal for the filter. It sounds like a good thing, but it really wasn't. It allowed all my oil to leak out of my motor, and they basically tried to say that it was my oil pump that failed, and then come to find out that wasn't the case. The case was that they actually left the other seal attached to the motor and then put the new oil filter over the top of that, and they put one on my car. Needless to say, with a little strong arm persuasion, I actually got them to settle the car out. And they weren't even willing to give me the insurance information at first, but I had to stand my ground, and I basically threatened them in front of a whole little room full of people, full of potential customers, so they didn't want anything to do with that, so they just gave me the information. Looks like maybe an old Kentucky Fried Chicken. It's a real funny day today out. It's overcast. see if we can get a different shot here. The other side. Here. What do we got here?
Tinted windows, that's privacy in public. Open bag, that's not privacy in public. So it's this one right here.
How are you, sir?
Good, how are you?
Can I help you with anything?
Nah, man, I'm just working on a story.
Okay. Are we getting tag numbers in there?
Whatever I can see, yeah.
Okay.
Like right here, you mean?
Yeah.
Or over here?
Okay.
Absolutely.
All right.
Somebody's calling the cops over here. He's concerned about the tags, obviously. A tag is put on there so the public knows what it is, so the public can read it. Yeah, this car right here, this car's got at least four.
busy road. We'll give you a quick look around the neighborhood. We got MVT across the street. We got the Price Chopper Plaza over here. If you look way in the back up there, you can see the steel tanks rising up there. I think there's five of them up there I can see. That's from the hood manufacturer built. So he came out very respectfully. It was really nice. He's probably just misinformed about what's considered private and public. Which we all know there is no privacy in public. There's your assumed privacy that you have. Looks like we got guys coming out outside over here too. Possibly meeting the police over here, but apparently not. Got a couple guys here. Privacy, they can put the vase down. I'm surprised we haven't gotten an owner out here. See from the sidewalk, you can record. See, we'll move on up a little bit here. We'll let these guys mellow with their feelings. Thank you. so good. Yeah, when you zoom out, there's a lot better stability. Liberty. I had one of those. They're a good vehicle until they're not. And then when they're not, they're horrible. Put $4,000 on it, and trying to bring it up to codes and never got it there. Yeah, this guy must be on the phone with somebody. The police, his boss.
There's a scary guy with a camera.
That guy's got a dual headlight on. Got a mask. Freaking things are everywhere now. Looks like we got another guy coming out here. Just working on a story, man.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah. Just getting some footage.
Oh, that's it?
Yep. You work here?
No.
Oh, no? Oh, yeah, yeah. I see you had the tires in your car. I was wondering if maybe that was a worker.
Oh,
later, man. Story.
That's the common theme everywhere, is working on a story. Alright, so, well, anyways.
Well, I'm doing, I've got a nice hat over here doing a cam back.
Cam back, hi!
Late on that. Late. Alrighty. Alright, so.
There's a lot of places for the police to actually be hiding around here, so I have no idea. I mean, obviously, I think they were called. Or he's on the phone with somebody. Other than the police. Chances are they're pretty educated out here in Oneida. They're not even going to show up. All right, we'll take a walk up here. We'll see what other businesses we got. Stand right in the front here. Excuse me?
What are you doing?
Video recording.
For what purpose?
My own personal purpose.
You have a reason?
Just videoing in public, right? I'm a side boy.
Okay.
You work here?
Yeah.
Cool.
A couple of people are getting weirded out.
All right, well, they can be weirded out in their own feelings.
All right. Could I ask why you do it, though?
For my own reasons, man. I'm working on a story.
What?
I'm working on a story.
Okay.
Head on down to the next one here. Get a couple shots for this one. Over here we got the Oneida Music Company. And they're not open today, it doesn't look like. So we still got some attention down there. You can see the guys are all outside. They're all wondering what I'm doing. Probably waiting for the police. Open today? Open? Maybe not open. So this is National Lube Express. Quaker State, Pennzoil, and Mobile. Looks like it's probably a little mom and pop shop. Doesn't look that big. I don't know if they're a nationwide thing or not. So they are an official New York State Motor Vehicle Inspection. National Express. Cooper Tires. So this is Silver City Tire. Looks like they do the same thing that everybody else is doing on this strip. Oh, we got a vape shop, guys. So there's our guys down there. Oh, they just left. They don't want to be on video. To the vape shop here just in a second. So I don't know about where you guys are from, but New York has some recently passed cannabis laws, and everybody thinks that marijuana is now legal, or is legal, and it's not. They have to open the first dispensary. It has to be open for a year in order for you to be able to grow your own. And it's a common misconception that, you know, it's just wide open and you can just grow whatever you want. That's not the case. You need a medical license. You need a medical license. And you can grow like 6 mature plants and 6 immature plants. So you can have a total, I believe it is 12. You need that medical license in order to do that. Okay, so it looks like we got somebody on their way out over here. The guy that just walked in seemed like he was a little interested. So right over there is the vape shop. Oh, oh.
Hey,
geez, snuck up on me there, bud. Just taking some video.
Okay, yeah, people were just nervous about that.
Well, it's gonna be... I'd like this to be more normal than it is, you know what I mean? I'm trying to make this normal, where people don't freak out when they see a camera.
Yeah, well, I think they...
Your name, sir?
People going through people's cars or...
Oh, I can... if a car's sitting here, I can walk right up to it. Zoom right in.
Can
do tags. They were concerned about me doing tags.
Yep. People obviously...
You know, I got you. Your name, sir?
It's Sergeant Hudson.
Sergeant Hudson, nice to meet you. My name's Rich. Yes.
Okay, can you
do last one? I'm gonna pass.
Okay, you local?
I'm gonna pass.
But that's a concern. Obviously, what you're doing legal, before people might call it.
Well, here's the thing. People have what they call perceived privacy. And it's their own perceived privacy, and it's how they feel about their privacy.
As long as you're on a public place.
Oh, yeah.
Visible,
or an easement.
Yeah.
So you might want to go down and talk to them guys down there.
You already did?
Because I believe they're the ones that called you.
Yep.
We got another guy over here, huh? What's up, boss? Can I get your name and badge number, sir? My name's Rich, sir. Nice to meet you.
Rich?
Yes.
All right.
Yeah, but I'm gonna be out here for a while. Oh, you don't got to worry about my safety.
I'm telling you, what you're doing is legal. People get anxious about it.
That's on them. But, you know, if they want to go to jail, that's on them.
All right.
Take it easy, man. Yeah, you too.
Pass in front of you there.
Yeah, go ahead. I'm going to back up here then for you to do that. So again... the Oneida police seem to be educated. So what we got here, we got a Connect Medical Company, which is in the middle right there, they're closed. Jackson Hewitt, and then we got a vape shop. So the vape shops always seem like they're very anxious to come out. And then when they do come out, they
they have nothing to say.
I just don't know why they do that. Duncan, that's one of the cops that I just encountered. It looks like he's gonna watch me. Train stone over here. She's a little concerned. It's all right to be concerned. Sergeant. So listen, if somebody calls you from over here, is this considered sovereign Indian property, or is that something you respond to also?
The nation. Yeah. Where the plaza right there?
Yeah, the Savon.
That's Oneida Indian Nation.
So you don't come out for that?
Nope.
Right, thank you. It's Sergeant Hudson, I believe it was. He didn't go in for a coffee. And that's all Oneida Indian over there. So it looks like that whole plaza is like an Oneida Indian plaza. You can see their logo like all over it. The Oneida Indian Nations. So we got a nice little presence here in the city of Oneida. You look, you can see it's all over in here. It probably wraps around too, I would imagine.